Yeah, that is in court at the moment, so I cannot answer that question. I'm sorry about that. The other issues as well, the court, I think you guys know what's happening, so I cannot comment right now. My apologies, but I cannot comment. Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Exactly what you do now is that you just do not need duplication. So
do you think it's going to kill the morale of some of
us? No. This is something good for us. You know, it brings us all together. It brings the synergies of all the three operating, the pipeline, the railway, together. We've been working with railway for a long time, as East Africa Harbors and railways and harbors. So we're just going back to the basics. What we can do for us is ensure a seamless service. The other operating entities knows what the other does. So when we combine and have a common strategy, we will actually increase the efficiency and the time taken to actually evacuate cargo here to where it's supposed to go, the factory is, and all that. So it's just got the synergies right. That is what we need to put.
And maybe there was some negotiation at higher level regarding
as well.
looked at some of the strategies maybe you're using in trying to tell your family, maybe you can tell us.
Right now we're actually trying to gazette that area. You know, we have a pinpoint where we want the facility to be, and we are progressing. SMEs will also be on site. Right now what we're doing, the study has been done, where we get the water, the electricity lines, where we're going to build these certain structures around, and it's at the moment we are trying to get them to somebody who's with productivity of COVID-19 by the 3 months should be done by next year, 2022. And then we'll commission it right when the time comes. And we have the new location of the cable terminal, which is right there. This, the old terminal has, you can only berth one ship at a time. This new terminal, which is it's an island terminal called, it will berth 4 ships at any one time. So there'll be less demurrage charges, there will not be penalties. So at the end of the day, these charges are not passed on to the consumer. So we'll be having it reduced rates of business. And from there, actually, the island, we can take a maximum shipping load of 170,000 tons dead weight. Yes, we can take 2 of them. The term and over 100,000 deadweight tonnage of 200. So we can bath any 4 ships at the same time. The pipes will be connected from the ship we're going to unload subsea about 1 kilometer away. It will travel below the sea. It's minus 26 meters. It's a trench. They will be able to carry gas oil. This will be actually congesting our ports. We'll bring up our capacity to 2.1 million. commodities will be at a cheaper prices according to what you're doing with them. Some health officers, six of them, so they're able to take tests at Militini for the truck drivers. So it kind of elevates the congestion that we have in the port. And that is where we're going now. And we're continuing to educate and ensure that we are actually in the right path of actually slowing down this.
Thank you very much for that.
We ensured as well that we have a public address system that was coming on every now and then, every hour, to just tell us what we should do. Social distancing, sanitizers, irrigation. That is all our facilities. We took care of all our facilities. And the shipping lines operating this route, every 48 hours there's a pre-arrival clearance. They should show us where were they the last 2 weeks, what ports they visited. And at that time there was no show leave for any crew member. Show leave is when a crew member is given some time off from the ship to go ashore, to the shops, or to the town, whatever he or she wants to like to do. So to stop that, no one is getting the ship. So these are mitigation factors that was handled. All, including the clinics, our health officers were fitted with special hazmat suits, gloves, so that they can treat our people. But at the moment, I just want to tell you something. We're the first government institution for the state to do mass testing. We did over 2,000 tests. And we've got a few now. We have 126 who are actually infected since the pandemic started. The situation of the port now is quite flat, you can say that. Eh? We started very badly. At one time we stigmatized its KPA having started this coronavirus in Mombasa. But once we got our first determination of corona, we lost a lady first, and then we lost another gentleman who was called in operation and admin. And we actually had a senior managers having to look after the COVID-19, the prevention measures that we have to take. We started with having hand washing machines all over the place, all over the facilities, at the workshops. We're sending fumigation, sanitizers, masks, and the temperature readers at the gates. And we've actually ensured that staff and our neighbors are actually sensitized on the issues about COVID and the pandemic, social distancing. We had to send a quarter of our staff to home, to work from home.